Hello and welcome to the Django Celery Mastery course. Just a quick reminder, if you like this course and would like to access the source code and more, you can access this course on Udemy. The link to the course, which should provide the best price, is in the video description. So now that we have developed or prepared the Django Celery working environment, let's move on and create and register our first Celery task in Django. What we need to remember here is that we are running Django in the container, and we have almost set up Django to primarily and solely work within that container. So if I were to try and start to run Django within the local environment here, it wouldn't work. And the main reason why that is because we're utilizing environment variables, which we aren't setting up here and making available when we run the Django project locally. So if I were to try and run any management commands here locally, this also wouldn't work because of the settings file having errors, being that it cannot find the environment variable. So we need to run the commands on the Docker container. So just make sure that Docker container has started and it's running. And let's go into the commands here. We have a command here, which we can then open up a new terminal in our Docker container. So this is going to be Docker exec, and then the IT interactive terminal, Django, that's the name of the service, the container. And remember, we've explicitly defined that as Django. If you haven't, then what you can do is, well, one thing that you can do is just go into Docker Desktop here and just copy the name of the container. And that will then give you access. But we've already renamed the container to Django to make it easier for us to port in. And then let's go ahead and access bin and shell. So we're going to start a new shell. There we go. So we're now inside of our Docker container. We can now run the manage.py command to then start a new app. And let's call this app let's call it worker, shall we? Or C worker. Okay, so although we have created a new app on the server, remember we have a volume here. So we're linking, there is a link, if you like, between the data on the container and our local hard drive here. So you can see that we have created a new app here locally as well. Okay, so that may be a little bit confusing, in actual fact. So I'm just going to move that to a trash. So remember that it's linked, so it will be removed on all of the containers. So let's just do that again. Let's call this something else. Let's call this new app. Okay, so we just know that is a new app. It was getting a little bit confusing with D Celery and C Celery and so on. So hopefully that makes a little bit more sense. Right, so we've got a new app. Inside of our Celery D Celery folder here, that's the main project folder. We're going to create a new file, celery.py. So what we're trying to do here is we want to initiate Celery so that we can pass messages to Celery so it can then perform actions such as then sending the task to the message broker. So let's first of all import OS. So this module provides us a way to interact with the operating system, including accessing any environment variables and setting default settings. We, of course, are going to need Celery. So from Celery, let's go ahead and import Celery. So this line is going to import Celery class from the Celery module. Celery, of course, is our task queue library used for asynchronous task processing. So that's what we're going to be utilizing. That's where we're going to pass the information about we want to run tasks over. And then Celery can then perform the operation of sending the task to the message broker. Now, typically, we're going to store any Celery-related settings in the Django settings file here. So at the bottom, we have the Celery broker URL and Celery results backend and so on. So we are going to need to access that, or Celery is going to need to be able to access those settings. Now, typically, when we start a new Django server, we go back into the desktop here, you can see the Django server is running. When we start this server, the manage.py file is almost the entry point for that. And you can see one of the commands or one of the settings that is defined is this environment variable, which is the Django settings module. So that needs to take place in order for us to actually be able to, say, access the Django settings and other functionality. So when we run the, let's go back into the Docker Compose file here. So when we run the Django server, we use this command. Now, because we're using the same code base for Celery here, and we're not running the Django server, that command isn't going to be initiated. So for us to, or for Celery to be able to access the settings, then we are going to need to initiate that. So I've just copied and pasted that from the manage.py file. We are going to initiate that before we can then go ahead and access or allow Celery to access the settings in the Django project. Okay, so just importing Celery isn't going to be enough. We're going to need to make a new instance. So let's go ahead and say app equals, and that's going to be a new instance of Celery. So we're going to instantiate Celery there. And then we're going to pass in a name, which is going to be the same name as our project folder here. So dcelery. So this name here, this argument dcelery, specifies the name of the Celery application. Right, so if you imagine now that the Celery application is now inside, or we can access the Celery application through app here. This is our variable app. So we can now go ahead and make some changes to Celery. So we can add, for example, different parameters, different settings. So let's go ahead and do exactly that. First thing we need to do is tell Celery about Django settings, or how to access Django settings. So let's go ahead and say app.config dot from object. Let's go ahead and set the django.conf settings, and then we'll give it a namespace. So namespace equals, well, the namespace has already been defined. We've already done that in settings. The namespace that we're using is Celery underscore. So namespace in this context just means that Celery looks through the settings file here, and it's going to look for any settings that starts with Celery underscore. So we don't need to specify the underscore in the namespace, just the name Celery. And that's how Celery is going to know whether the setting is related to Celery or not. So we use the namespace to distinguish Celery settings in the settings file. For a basic setup of Celery, that is all that we're going to need at this point. So we're now ready to think about creating tasks. Like Django views, we can create tasks utilizing functions or classes. So here we have the option of creating functions whereby we use declarators to indicate to Celery that the fact that this function is a Celery task, or we can use classes and follow the same type of approach. Now, whenever we create a new task in Celery, we will need to register that task to Celery. That's the important part. Now, let's go ahead and first of all, we'll create a task here in the Celery file. Now, as I probably already indicated already, a Celery task is just a function or a class which performs some sort of action. So let's go ahead and create, and we will be using a function based at this point. So we'll go ahead and build a new function. Let's just call this add numbers. So we're not actually going to add any numbers at the minute, but we will do as we move forward. So just going to create a basic function there, and then we're just going to return. Okay, so there's our function. That's what we want to perform. That's our Celery task, if you like. Now at the moment it's just a function. We do want to make it into a Celery task. So all we need to do here is use a declarator at app. Okay, so app, and then we can use dot task. Okay, so we just declarate this function with the app task. That's one approach. And now Celery now has a new task. Now by using app.task, we are registering this task with Celery. So Celery can find this task and then be ready to actually execute this task whenever it is requested. Adding functions here in the Celery module here probably isn't going to be the most flexible approach to building Celery tasks. We may want to integrate tasks or indicate the fact that we want to start tasks inside of our apps, views, models, and so on. So we want a more flexible approach. So in addition to creating tasks with app task, we also have shared tasks. Right, so we created this new app here. Let's just make sure that in the settings we've actually added it to the installed apps. So let's call this new app. Okay, so just register the Django app here. And now Django knows about this app so that we can work with it. So let's go into our views here. Right, so let's just make a new task. So we're going to call this function, this is add numbers. So let's call this function shared task. So I'm just going to call it shared task for now, and then just return. Again, it's just a basic Python, a regular Python function. Now this time we're going to use the declarator at and then shared task. Okay, so the shared task declarator simplifies the process of creating celery tasks within a Django project. It's going to eliminate the need for us to actually import app into our view, and then we could change that then. So we import app, we could then just say app.task again here if we wanted to. So we could import app if we wanted to, but shared task is going to make our work, or it's going to make it a lot easier for us to work or create tasks throughout our applications. Of course, in terms of reusability, our code, it also makes our code much more reusable because we're not trying to import a separate resource from a different app, or in this case, the main project folder. Right, okay, so we've got two approaches at the minute, app.task and shared task. Now, like I mentioned, utilizing app.task, we are registering this task to or with Celery. So Celery is aware now of this task. Now, Celery doesn't know anything about this shared task. So we do need to, or we need a way of telling Celery to look for other tasks within the project. So to do that, very simply, we're going to be utilizing app and then the auto discovered tasks. Okay. So this is an approach whereby we are now informing Celery to look for all the other modules. So if I go back into settings here in installed app, it's going to look for all the installed apps, and then it's going to look for a file, and that file is going to be called, actually, that is a very good point. It's going to be called tasks.py. So in actual fact, we need to move our shared task from the view. And let's go ahead and create a new file here. Let's call this tasks.py. Let's add that in there. Okay, so Celery is going to look for the tasks files. It's going to then find the shared task declarator and then register the shared task as a Celery task. Now we are going to have to import shared task, so let's not forget to do that. So from Celery, let's go ahead and import shared task. Okay,